Hello adventure riders, as I promised at the beginning of my trip, I'm gonna make a detailed proper video review of Kyler 650. And not only this bike, also this bike, which is belong to my friend Sasha. Actually both bikes belong to Sasha, but I will talk about it and he will add some very, very valuable information, I believe. All right, I will start first with some specifications. It's a very well-known brand and model. They build it for more than 20 years. They produce it actually for more than 20 years. So I have nothing really to surprise you, but just will tell you a brief specifications. This is 650cc, single cylinder. It delivers something between 34 and 37 horsepower. I read somewhere 44 horsepower, but I'm not sure. I believe that is something like 37 horsepower, which is not much on paper, but it's actually more than enough for this bike because it is just not that it's not that the type of the bike which you will ride fast. It has a 21 inch front wheel, and which is good if you want to go off the roads, and it has 17 on the back. And let me sit on it so you can see how it sit me ergonomically. You see, I'm 185, little above 6 feet, and for me it's perfect now because I have a bar risers, but I will show you later on Sasha's bike how exactly it suit me. The petrol tank is 23 liters, and the range of this bike is proven by me not less than 450 kilometers. In the worst scenario, you're gonna have 400 kilometers, which is more than enough. It's a carburetor, old-fashioned engine, run with any kind of petrol. I use it mostly 95 and 90 91, but it works absolutely without any problems. Because I don't want to forget something, I've got a list of the things I want to talk about it. Okay, the first point is that I've got 12,000 trouble-free kilometers. So as you already saw in my videos, I got this bike and I rode it on any kind of terrains: highways, back roads, dirt roads, gravel roads, muddy roads, rocky roads, whatever roads I pointed, the bike just goes and goes and goes and goes. Never complain, never stop, so do I. The bike is just perfect for the purpose I need it. This is just, with few words, I will say that the bike is just perfect to explore Australia, New Zealand, or countries like that. Some people might say, ah, this is only 37 horsepower, it's not enough. All right, but the speed limits in Australia on the highways are 110 kilometers per hour. How much you can get? The fines are very expensive, so it's not a place to make experiments with a powerful bike. Okay, the next point I want to talk, it has absolutely easy and cheap maintenance. The oil, you can change it by yourself for 10 or 15 minutes. It's absolutely simple. It's not a rocket science. It's just to unplug, drain it, and put the new oil. Nothing like it. It's not like my Yamaha Tenere. It has a little bit complicated procedure because it's a dry sump. The next one, it's used between 4 and 5 liters petrol per 100 kilometers. Most of the time is something like 4.4. You can't get more than 5, but you cannot get more than 4. This is definitely proved by me. The cruising speed of this motorcycle is something like 100-110 kilometers per hour. This is the maximum. You can go to 130-40-50 for a short period of time, but you cannot ride all day around on that speed. It's just impossible. That's why I said 100-110. This is the speed you can get. It's a very light bike. It is, by the specifications, it's at 194 kilograms wet with petrol, with oils, with everything, which is made this bike like 10 kilograms lighter than my Yamaha Tenere 660. But when you jump on it, you feel it like a 30 kilograms lighter. I don't know why. Maybe because the front is very light. It has only one disc on the front, which is 280 millimeters. And the forks, I don't know. But it's just lighter, significantly lighter from when you jump from Yamaha to this bike. This is what I felt. Okay, a few things I really like on that bike. So the first one is simplicity. It's such a simple bike. You don't have to know anything. You just go on it, ride it, and it's exactly like made for you. And because of this old carburetor, all this, let me show the dashboard what it is. Hold on this for a while, Sasha. Look at what it is. It has very simple dashboard, and what I like is this analog style. You have the RPMs, you have the speed, you have the temperature gauge. That's it, and few simple lights, neutral indicators, high beam or low beam, whatever. You don't need anything else, and just one button to make zero your mileage. That's it, absolutely simple. The instruments and the tools it has, nothing like every motorcycles you ever seen. Absolutely simple. This is what I like, simplicity. All right, give me the list to see what else it was. What I like also, I like the metal petrol tank. This make the thing so much easier if you want to have like a tank bag. So for my Yamaha, for example, the tank is from plastic, and if you want to have a tank bag, it needs to be with straps, and this makes the things a little bit more complicated. And the choices of the tank bag, of course, not so many. I like the fact that it has this petrol tank from metal. What I like also, the seat. It has flat seats, which I spoke a lot about it, especially when you make a plans to ride for a long period of time or when you want to go off the road. If you have a flat seat, it will give you the chance to move forward or backward to distribute the weight better if you need to, which is a very good a pros. I love it, and as I said, I've done more than 12,000 kilometers on that bike. Some of the days I've got like 700-800 kilometers per day, and I was absolutely fine. The stock seat is just good, much better than Tenere. I like the oil window. Let me show you this. It has this oil window here on the bottom, which is very, very useful. Can you tilt it for me, Sasha? So you can tilt it like that and you see the oil. So you can control the oil level of your bike all the time without need to check it with a oil stick like the Tenere, which is a little bit more complicated. I told you about analog clocks. The mirrors are, even though they look pretty old-fashioned, actually the visibility in the mirrors is very good, so I like it. And I have a few things I don't like. What I don't like, well, I don't like the fenders. Have a look now this. Why the hell they built such a big and wide fender? Look at this. Look at how, what is the size of the tire and what is the size of the fender. Such a big fender. I don't think that is so necessary. The next point is this luggage rack. See how big it is. Why the hell they built such a big luggage rack? But anyway, all of this could be easily changed. And the next one I don't like, it's the front fender. I know what is the purpose of the high front fender. I've got even a video about it. Everybody will say, no, the mud will stuck between. I know all about it, but why they build it such a big and such a wide? Look at this. When you ride on the windy conditions, it's like a sail. It's like a sail. Actually, the wind blow you up left and right. And another one thing I don't like is the way the seat is removed. So to remove the seat, you need 8mm socket, which is from here, two bolts, fair enough. And this is where the stock kit is, which is good idea of the stock kit to have it here, so you can just open it and use it anytime. But the problem is that in the stock kit, the original kit, you don't have 8mm socket. So if you want to remove your seat and to check the battery or something, you need to have an additional tool kit, and then you can do it. Could be easily managed like a Yamaha, just with the key, or the most of the bike you just use the key and remove the seat. This is what I don't like. And okay, another one point I want to say is the coolant reservoir. It is hidden here underneath, which is fair enough, but to fill it up you need to remove all of these plastics, otherwise you can't do it. So you can check it from here, you can check the level from here. From here you can check the level, but you can't fill it. To fill it, you have to remove all of this plastic. It could be designed a little bit better, but anyway, it's an old-fashioned bike, so nothing really to complain. Another one thing I like is the size of the brake pedal. You see how small it is, and it has this small curvature here instead of having a big metal part like that, which will be the first thing you're gonna bend when you go down. It has just a small curvy shape, which is good. Another one minus I notice are the foot pegs, the original foot pegs. It's easy to be changed, but for the Yamaha, for example, you can remove the rubber and use just the metal parts. You can't remove it on that. That's it, and the things I don't like. Let me see what I want. what else I wanted to talk. All right, no. Now, conclusion. This bike, it's for me absolutely perfect choice for adventure motorcycle. You can ride it anywhere, anytime, any terrains. First of all, it is very cheap, and I will be absolutely honest with you. If this bike was existing in Europe, I'll be more than happy to buy it because they are cheap, to modify it for my needs and ride it without any problems in the next 5 years. But they don't, does not exist. So I don't have this option anymore. And now, because I'm afraid the video will be a little bit longer, but anyway, I'll take this risk and we'll talk a little bit longer. I want to show you a few things I have made already just to improve my comfort when I was riding. So I add this 2.5 centimeter bar risers here, which will give me the chance to raise the handlebar and also tilt it a little bit forward to make a better comfortable position for me. It came with this USB plug here, which is good if you want to recharge something. And I also add this 12 volt socket to use it for my GPS. It has also heated grips, which are added later. But these are actually the things I made it in the later stage. All right, now I'm gonna switch the mic to my friend Sasha and we'll ask him a few questions. So he might add some information about it.
You want me to hold it, Jeff?
No. I'll put it for you, Sasha. All right, put this in your pocket. All right, Sasha, do you have something to add to everything I already said?
Well, basically, bike's good. The three things I told you before, police don't see you. That was my always problem because I had road bikes.
Why they don't see you?
Because they don't look at those bikes. They look at the sports bikes, the R bikes, the sports tourers. Also, another thing, just basically switch it on and go. I never had any problem with it. Wherever I took it, it always starts. And the third point I forgot now.
So how about the maintenance? Is it easy to do?
Easy. This one never been in Kawasaki or to any dealer. I did everything myself. And like Pablo said before, it takes you 10, 15 minutes. Mm.
It just goes and goes, yeah?
Just goes.
And you have a high screen, yeah?
Yeah, I got that. I got this bike for $8,000 when I bought it. It had this screen, tank bag, another two bags on the side and one on the top. So it was a pretty good deal. And the heated grips I got.
Heated grips.
Only thing I added was the Lex. Both got Lex exhaust. This one, the green one, and this one. Just, they sound like a lawnmower on the original. There's the original one and it's really heavy. Mm-hmm. So on this, it's just, you just punch it and it goes nice. Beautiful.
All right. Thank you very much, Sasha. And something now, some important information I want to add now, because this bike now, the green one, is for sale. Why you sell it, Sasha?
Because I got two, I don't need two anymore.
I
bought this one for you, so you can ride it around, and if you trash it, I didn't care.
Yeah.
I gave it to you, you looked after it, and now it's for sale. I really don't need two bikes.
Okay. Cool. So the bike is actually for sale, and what is the price you ask?
$5,000.
$5,000. The price he asks is $5,000, and if you call it now in the next week, he will give you for free. Show it, guys. Show this. Show this
stuff.
Put it on the bike, Sasha. Put it on the bike. Yeah, it's all right.
Oh, it's from the last trip, but the original KLR bags.
Yeah, so if you call in the next week, you'll have this original KLR box for free, and the top one. Yeah, the original KLR box for free, and you also got this simple tank bag here, so you can put your telephone or some documents. And let me show you once again around. It has these bar risers, it has heated grips, 12 volt, USB, everything exactly as you see it. The bike was ridden from me. For 12,000 kilometers, at the moment it has 24,880, almost 25,000 kilometers, absolutely trouble-free. And I can confirm that the bike was dropped only once by me from the side stand, because the side stand, the angle of the side stand is not really well. So the bike fell down only once, but the bike was not even moving. This is the only drop it has. The tires are TKC70. They are almost worn out, but they will get easily more 2,000 to 3,000 kilometers without any problems. So this is the situation. Everything works. Sasha, can you start the engine, please? Just put the shock because it's...
Before I start, I remember the third thing. The third thing is...
Hold on for a second. What is the third one? Hold it.
The third thing is that with this bike, you drop it, you put some scratches, it's like in a battle scars. You don't care about it. Well, when you have a flash bike or something, you don't want it to be scratched. I was always paranoid dropping the... I never dropped the bike, any bike except this one. And to be honest, I don't care. I reckon it looks better now. Yeah. All right, you want me to start it, yeah?
In many ways, it's look better, yeah, when it's a scratch. Yeah, start the engine, just put the shock. The shock is so just to see. It's always start, no problems whatsoever. It doesn't matter how hot it is or how cold it is. It's always work. Yes. All right, that's it, guys. Long and I hope informative video for those of you who are planning to have this type of bike. Don't forget, if you get it now, you're gonna have all of this stuff. And in the video description, I will leave Sasha details, his email and his telephone. So if you want to get in touch, just go and call him. As usual, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next time.
Ciao.